Hey guys, it's Nate, aka The Foot Accountant. Welcome back to the channel. Oh, do we have a video today, guys? EA has just dropped a gameplay patch out of nowhere that has nerfed the sprint slash speed boost on this game and long ball passes, and it is making cards absolutely crash on the market. It is crazy, some of the price drops that we have seen in this game. Now, there's another reason why prices are crashing too, and we'll talk about that, but we're getting free packs today as well. If you did those FC24 objectives during that preseason promo, today is the day when we're expecting to see those packs given to us, and it should be around the content drop time. We're going to talk about that today, and of course, on top of all that, we've got Division Rivals rewards and hopefully a market rise that we can invest in and make some profit off of. So if you're excited for today, drop a thumbs up and of course subscribe if you are new. Now, let's talk about yesterday's content. We haven't even mentioned it yet. EA dropped the big max 87 base hero upgrade SBC. They actually did it yesterday, guys. So now mark that down. Remember that one. Wednesdays maybe are the new days that we're getting the icon and the hero upgrades. Very interesting schedule this year so far, especially with this dropping yesterday. Now let's get to the pack. It's an 86 with an inform and an 85 rated squad. Maybe just a shade more expensive than we were hoping it to be. Remember, we were looking for just an 86 rated squad or an 84 and 85. 120,000 coins isn't horrendous value, and I think maybe since the SBC is a little bit more expensive, like we do look at a lot of times, the cheaper SBCs for gamble packs like this usually have terrible weight. This one actually doesn't have the worst of weight, guys. Honestly, we opened a bunch yesterday on stream. We didn't see any Jopstams or Hamshiks or anything like that, but we did see Sydney Govu a decent number of times. We did see a couple of good cards like Harry Kuhl was semi-common. Smolarek was packed out of it. Captivia, that's a decent card, right? I think the way that it splits out with a number of cards that are above the price of the SBC and the number of cards that are below that 120,000 coin value, it's actually like a 50-50 split for, you know, the number of heroes in the 87 range that are either below that price and above that price. So it's not bad. I think it's worth crafting over the 6 days that it's out. I don't think you have to get it done right away. Of course, a lot of people were. I obviously was not. I had just spent coins on getting Varane done. I didn't want to spend more coins on fodder for this. I'm waiting for my Division Rivals rewards today to probably open those and get this done. I think that'll be my grind. But of course, with those packs that we're getting later today from FC24, that's going to be easy craftability for this type of SBC. So it is nice to do for the price that it is. I think it's just very hype because it's the first hero upgrade of the year. I think it's worth a shot over the next week, however you can craft it. Now, of course, with this being out, guess what's up? SBC fodder on that middle tier. 85s are 5K, 86s are almost 8,500 coins, and 87s are actually down just a little bit. These were about 15,000 coins yesterday for a short bit. A lot of fodder had a move like this. Fodder just kind of had like a boom, like a spike right at content, and then went back down, except for 86s have kind of continued to stay high. Now, I'm really curious to see how Rivals Rewards is going to impact some of these prices today. I would expect a drop on fodder, and then potentially a bit of a rise after that. So if you want to be trading during the Rivals Rewards on bids with fodder, I think that could be a move. I'd look at 85s, 86s, and 87s, because there were still being people today, kind of like myself, who are looking for those Rivals rewards to give them the fodder to do this SBC, to do the Kefram Taram, or maybe even Varane SBCs that are still out in this game. Now, hero prices as well. We'll talk about the market impact in a second, but hero prices didn't really explode, or you know, there wasn't even a lot of panic on the hero prices either. We look at like Jopstam as an example card here. He's up for sure, but it's like he's one of the cards that it kind of bounced really well. He went from like 830k up to 920, 930 where he is now. But a lot of the other hero cards that were in this, like Cordoba, I think he's another card that had a bit of a bounce, but he's even back down now at 535. So like yesterday he was 509, went up to 550. Now back down to 535. So it's not like the heroes that are at the top tier of this pack that are like unpackable. They didn't crash a whole lot before this pack was released, so they didn't rebound a ton. And also some of the heroes at the bottom, some of the most commonly packed ones like Noor and stuff like that, it's not like those cards are absolutely tanking either. Some of them are down, but a lot of the heroes are just kind of in the same range that they were before. Now there are some that are up or down a little bit, but since there wasn't a whole lot of either panic for this beforehand or selling before it actually was released, the market movements based off of this weren't really that crazy. Honestly, the craziest movements on this were the fodder prices going up. And right when this was dropped, since it was a bit of a surprise, you saw the beginning of the crash that happened on the market yesterday. Take a look at gold Jude Bellingham. Yesterday, he was 254,000 coins a couple hours before content. Right around content, he was about 240. When this Max 87 hero came out, a lot of prices crashed for like a short 15 to 20 minute time period. This Jude Bellingham was actually about 220,000 coins. It doesn't even show here. It was so low, so fast. It doesn't show on the graph, but he started to rebound right back up from that as people were selling cards. They were going to the market to sell cards to go and complete this SBC because they had to go buy the fodder, right? So the fodder goes up because there's more demand for that. And then people were selling other cards in their team to go and afford this pack. And you saw these cards crash. Now, they rebounded pretty quick. What's another card? Saliba, I think, was like all the way down at 215K, and he rebounded back to 230. So there was a kind of a quick window here where you could snipe low and then sell as the card went back up. But if you look at the market index overall, which is somewhere here in my tabs, look at this. The market just absolutely tanked right away after content yesterday as a lot of people were selling cards to go ahead and do the new hero SBC. Now, we're going to talk more about the market in a minute, but that was kind of the beginning of the market drop yesterday, was this piece of content. Now, we did have two other player SBCs released yesterday as well. I want to cover those really quick. We had Angelo Stiller. This is the Stiller that we thought we were going to get from Stuttgart, center defensive mid. It is an 84 rated squad with an inform is what it is. So if you want to get that done, you can go ahead and do that. And then we have a challenge SBC, which is worth mentioning because Premier League center attack in mids, I believe, check your club. I'm not sure if they're still expensive, but Premier League center attack in mids were at one point like 3K, 2 to 3,000 coins. So check your club for those right now because I do believe that they have gone up in price. Now, the other part of content yesterday was the team of the week, which in my opinion might be the most mid team of the week that we have had yet. A lot of fodder cards in here, a couple interesting ones. Bukayo Saka and Valverde probably lead the charge as the best cards in this team of the week. Mane looks like a cheap beast as well if he needs Saudi League links, but not a bad team of the week, just not super amazing. And a lot of these prices I would expect to see dipping today with the rivals rewards as we normally see as well. Saka is 189,000 coins. I think as well the gold card, he was down at 27, now he's up at 29, and then Fede Valverde's gold card is still chilling nicely up from 420 where he was on Monday when we first started looking at him. He's now 460K. That should probably go up today with Division Rivals rewards, but these cards will probably drop a bit. You know, maybe you can trade with Saka or Valverde or Mane today, but a lot of these look like kind of fodder or just cheaper team of the weeks in general. Now, let's get to the good stuff, guys. This is where the news on this game and really a big surprise from EA mixed everything up yesterday. Guys, EA dropped a live, what do they call it? A live tuning update to the gameplay. It's technically not an update or a gameplay patch because you don't have to go and download anything specific. Literally, it's just when you reset the game, when you close out of the game and come back into it, it will have a tuning update and the gameplay will be different. This is something that they implemented, I think, for the first time in FIFA 23 or maybe last year in FC 24, these live tuning updates. But this was the biggest thing. They even mentioned it in their tweet. It's now available and it reduces instances of players accelerating unintentionally quickly when a sprint is requested. Now, this is the message that popped up in game as a lot of us were playing and we saw this, is reduces instances of players accelerating unintentionally quickly when a sprint is requested, aka the L1 speed boost, L1 sprint boost that a lot of people have been using. And it's actually made a lot of cards. Maybe you didn't even realize it. It's made a lot of those types of cards that have rapid plus and quick step plus overly priced on the market. Like this Rafael Leao was 500,000 coins. And with this patch being released, making these cards basically less overpowered and less broken than they were before, their prices have dropped like crazy. This Rafael Leao was 500,000 coins, as I mentioned. He just was below 400K and had a little bit of a rebound. But what I want to talk with you guys about this is, it's not like this speed boost, sprint boost is gone. It is still actually good in game. As you can see here, you remember before how when you did the L1 sprint boost, it would just like absolutely teleport you ahead of where you were at. Now it just gives you kind of like a little bit of an extra boost. You can see here the turn with Diani, boom. She still gets a little bit of a boost there in terms of pace. And I even tested this as well when I was playing on stream yesterday. It's still noticeable and it's still there. It reminds me of the Finesse Plus nerf that happened last year in FC24. Everybody was freaking out that finesses were going to be absolutely nerfed to the ground. They weren't going to be good in game anymore. And still players that had Finesse Plus, like remember that Trailblazers Hansen, Gold Sun, Gold Salah, they got panic sold. But they rebounded part of the way back up because they were still so useful and very useful in game. And that's kind of what's happening with Rafael Leao right now and some of the other players like Nico Williams. But still, their prices are down heavy. Just to show you the graph, this is the Rafael Leao right now. Yesterday, he was 505,000 coins. This news comes out. He tanks all the way down for a couple hours, down to 390. I was able to buy one right here, and I sold it just a couple minutes ago at 435,000 coins just for the quick flip. He's not going to go back up to 500K. Again, his card's not as broken as it was before. It's still good, just not as broken, right? And it's going to hurt these prices for sure. Nico Williams is 86K. Some of the special cards that have been hurt by this, Trinity Rodman, her inform card was like almost extinct at 280, like 300,000 coins. She's now 250. She was 240K. Usman Dembele, Adeyemi, he was up a lot. He's now down some. So just keep an eye on these quick step and rapid players because they're still very useful and very meta because pace is always meta in this game, right? Always. So for people that, like panic selling these cards and thinking they're going to be absolutely useless, no, that's not it. These cards are still going to be very useful. Rafael Leao is still, especially with the Serie A links and all the links that he has right now, potential link to a Pulisic Player of the Month that we're still waiting for, still very meta. And I wouldn't be like, oh my gosh, I got to redo my team right now. I will say this, a lot of people are looking to the market and trying to figure out, and they're trying to like get in the know already, what is the next meta? Because everybody's worried about what is the next meta. I think the L1 sprint boost and still the long ball passes are still going to work. They're going to work more as intended though and more balanced in the game than they were before, which was pretty much broken. Now, a lot of people are starting to think that technical plus is going to be the OP chemistry style. I've seen some people tweeting about it already, and I think it's just been good this whole entire year, but the L1 sprint boost has taken all of the hype and all of the news and all the talking points. So I've actually picked up a couple of cards that have technical plus because I've seen so many people tweeting about it that it makes me think it's going to make some of the cards rise up a little bit in value. I showed the Joe Cole, the Messi, even some of the icon cards. Just watch these prices today. If you're trading from a trading aspect, or if you just want to go try somebody on the market, you know, I think technical plus has been good from the beginning of the game this year, but it's been over kind of shadowed by the sprint boost. So that's the situation there. I have to mention long ball pass on Guijarro because obviously she's kind of like the main card that people use for that. She went from 47,000 coins down to 38K and she's rebounding back up a little bit too. Again, maybe if you've never been able to afford Rafael Leao and him dropping this almost 100,000 coins makes you able to afford him, yeah, go try him out. Definitely give the card a go. But these prices are still probably going to be a little volatile as this news is spreading throughout the community and prices are going to be moving with all of that. Now, with prices on the whole market crashing as well, because this kind of sprint boost, speed boost market crash like we looked at here with the market dropping in its own self, like because of the hero pack as well, it's kind of made the whole rest of the market drop down. Now, prices, as you can see here, bottomed out about a couple hours ago, and they're starting to go up towards Rivals rewards. But we saw this sort of thing last week too. There should be another dip at Rivals, and the question is, are we going to see a nice rise after Division Rivals rewards today? I'm hoping so, because I've invested in a few things. I haven't gone crazy though. Like this Mohamed Salah 220, that's looking real cheap. That's looking pretty low. That's a card that I'm kind of interested in. But you see a lot of the cards in here, they have some green on them, right? That means that Footbin is noticing their card prices have gone up. Chiesa was under 110, now he's 115. I picked up a couple of Sam Kerrs. Actually, it might have been just one. I think I only bought one. I picked up a Sam Kerr at 78,000 coins. What is she right now? She's above 80K. So yeah, wow. So the market is starting to rebound a little bit before rewards here. I think if you want to buy in on some gold cards, or if you want to go safer than gold cards, because I was mentioning a little bit at the beginning of the video, we do have big news potentially coming today, guys. There's rumors circling that the new Total Rush promo is insane. Like, big name players, and it's a lot of hype, which, again, like we talked about yesterday, it seems like the type of promo that EA would want to bring a lot of hype for because, of course, it is about the brand new game mode that they've put into this game this year, Rush, that they've kind of pumped up so much already. I think we're going to be watching that very, very closely today, but watch out for the leagues. I think, though, the market can still have a nice rise today as people still are going to go play games, and, of course, we know that every single week, with the rewards that we get a lot of coin injection and a lot of people were going and buying teams. This is last week. Sam Kerr went from 106 to 126. That's why one of the reasons when I saw her at 76, 77K last night or just a couple hours ago, I was like, I got to snag one. So I wish I would have bought some more. But what I would tell you to do is the higher rate of the card, the better, the more meta the card, the better as well. So obviously people are trying to figure out what is the new meta. Some people think it's Ariel, some people think it's the technical plus, like we mentioned. But if you find something that's rare, something that if you look back through some of the graphs on Footbin, you see its price moving each and every week, I think it's an okay day to be picking up some stuff. And if you want to be the lowest amount of risk possible, look for out of packs informs. Martinelli in the low 50s is a great price. Some Road to the Knockouts from yesterday got really, really low. I just bought a Doku in the panic of the rapid quick step plus market crash here with the sprint boost for like 710, sold them for 790. Cherokee was really, really low yesterday. Some team of the week cards have been fluctuating down. Some of them are up. Sun is up a lot. Some of them down though, right? So I think there could be opportunities. Remember, a lot of teams that people are building right now, maybe Serie A still in links because of the Taram brothers that have SBCs that are out right now and Rafael Varane. So that's something to kind of remember. I think there will be good opportunities to make coins today, and I think the market should rise a bit. I just wonder if some of the leaks maybe hamper the rises a little bit as we get towards content. We'll have to see. Last thing I want to mention as I was looking at these Road to the Knockout cards is investing in these cards today, because last week, this is when the cards from Team 1 were the cheapest. Now, as I'm looking up Garnacho right here, question is, how much do you want to pay for these cards? It's going to just kind of come down to looking at the card, where the price has been in the past couple of days, and just trying to get it on an undercut and on a slight, because once again, these are live cards that upgrade. There's a lot of people, I think, that want to buy a Garnacho. There's also a lot of people, I think, that want to invest in a guy like Ruben Loftus-Cheek, and I understand why people want to do that, but I think what you need to watch for today is a bit of a price dip with rivals, and if there's not much of a price dip, I don't know, that I don't like that. I like buying a card like this for an investment if it's in packs when there is a dip. So I would just say for each player that you maybe are looking to invest in, make sure that there's a bit of a dip in price before you go all in, especially with the promo that could potentially become this weekend. Again, I'm a little leery on that as well. And these cards are more supplied than Team 1 of Road to the Knockouts, it seems. But if we see some big drops in price on the Impacts Team 2, I think that could create an investing opportunity today. And same thing with Team of the Week 4, the new cards that came out. Like I already mentioned, these cards should drop today with rewards. So watch out for that supply. Now, speaking of packs, we got to talk about the packs that a lot of us are going to be getting today. And it's going to bring up a question of, do you hold those packs or do you open them for what is out right now? It is these packs right here that a lot of us are going to be getting today. And I remember talking about it a lot at the end of FC24. Like, guys, these are packs you really want to do. Remember chasing all the way to level 30 for that Ronaldinho to get that 84 times 5? We're going to be able to open that today. A lot of fodder, but all of these packs are supposed to be, unless EA messed them up, because there was a mistake on one of these last year, they all are supposed to be untradeable packs, guys. An 80 plus times 10, an 84.5, an 82.10, 82.5, and an 81.7. Those are all the packs that you could be getting today if you did all the objectives from last year in FC24. Now, the question is, what is this going to do to the game today? Basically, this is going to supply with people with a lot of fodder, but it also might supply people with some players that they could put in their team, specifically some gold cards in that mid to low tier rating. So that's why I'm a little skeptical on some cards today rising up because of this, because of the leaks. I do believe there could be less of a rise today just because of some of this. Now, again, these cards are all going to be untradeable pack from this. And I really think that when EA give out a lot of fodder packs like this, especially for right now in this game where there's a decent number of SBCs, what's actually going to happen is the fodder that people need to go complete other SBCs is probably going to go up. So I think if you're watching fodder today during rewards, this might be one of the best places to try to invest. 88s maybe if you get them at like 16K on bid. You know what? People get a bunch of 85s and 6s from those packs today and think, ooh, I'm going to go do Varane. But for the 87 and 88 rated squads, what do they need? Maybe an 88, maybe an 89. Maybe there's opportunities to invest in some of these fodder ratings. I think the higher ratings give the best opportunity, but even the 85, 6s, and 7s, because that hero pack is probably still going to be one of the most completed SBCs today, that will probably be one of the more grindy ways, but one of the best ways to profit today. I don't think that the packs they're going to give out today are going to crash the market. No way, because again, these packs are untradeable. I think it's actually going to inflate the market in terms of fodder because, like I said, it's going to make people go and do more SBCs. Wow, that Ramirez went for 801 on bid. That's a very low price. I wish I could have bought that. I also, as you saw my transfer list, I picked up a Barcola for 405 just because he's mad rare. He fluctuates a ton. And I'm hoping to flip that for about 440 to 450 before Rivals comes around. And then I'll be able to just take the quick flip there. So that's the content for today, guys. Market crashing right now. Hopefully going to go up today because of Rivals. And then also we're getting a lot of packs today. Now, I want to mention really quick at the end of the video, other stuff to watch out for today on Thursday. Per usual, we're looking for the weekly objectives refresh, which will give out some more SP and it'll probably help a lot of us get to a further level than we have been currently in FC 25. Maybe you're going to be able to get yourself to like level 30, level 33, level 30, I don't know, Adama Traore level 38, wherever he is, 39. Yeah, 38. Maybe you're able to get towards the end here. So some good packs back here as well. And again, you're faced with the question, save or open. I think I'm going to open, like I said, my Rivals rewards. I'm going to save my other packs because it just seems like with Mbappe being the player that has leaked so far for this next promo of Total Rush, I just have to imagine there's going to be some other big players and maybe a big SBC player as well. So I'm going to hold out a little bit of my fodder just to see what this Total Rush promo looks like. But I do want to do the hero pack, and hopefully my Rivals rewards can help me towards that today. Maybe do a couple of upgrade packs too to get myself that fodder. So I think marquee matchups, the weekly objective refresh, maybe a couple of all other small things in here as well for Thursday content, but I'm not expecting a whole lot besides the MM supply. I think if you are buying some cards for the flips today, I believe if you want to have no risk in it, the best time to sell would be before the content drop, especially if it's a gold card, because I do believe, like I mentioned, that at 6 p.m. content today, that is when we would get our packs that we're expecting, those pre-order packs from the preseason promo. Sorry, not pre-order packs, the preseason packs, the carry forward ones, the free ones that we're getting today from those objectives in FC 25. So that's the video for me today, guys. Let me know in the comments what you're maybe looking to buy today. If you want to buy a team for a longer term hold, I don't think it's yet. I'm still a little leery about what's coming tomorrow with Total Rush. I think this is, if you're buying, you're investing for a quick flip. I wish I would have bought more Sam Kerrs now at 77K, seeing that she's 82, 83. And I did pick up some Boshas because if people are trying out like the aerial meta and stuff like that, also France links are obviously in demand at the moment. I thought that 12K for her was really, really cheap because she has whipped pass plus. And yeah, I was like, you know what, let's try it. So she's still around 12,000 coins and she dropped off a lot, but I did buy a couple of those. So that's kind of my investments at the moment, that Barcola. And then I do have three Messis here and a Cherki, hoping the Messis can go up to about, I don't know, like 210, 215, something like that. And then Cherki is just a live card and he's rare. So hopefully he goes back to like 250. He's been 270 in the last couple of days. So we'll see, but that's kind of what we're doing on the account right now. Hoping for a market rise today, hoping to make a few coins, and we'll see what surprises EA and the leaks will have for us today. So if you're excited for this Total Rush promo and mid the packs today, and if you have any questions about the market crash as well, drop it down below in the comments. I'll be checking it out down there. But if you enjoyed today's video, drop thumbs up on it, and of course, subscribe if you're new. I will see you guys in the stream today. It's been TheFutAccountant. See you there. Peace out.